How did CrowdStrike allow this to happen? Is there something different about Windows that makes it more vulnerable to this kind of stuff?
Windows does allow third-party companies like CrowdStrike to install kernel modules, drivers, right into the kernel, the base of the operating system. And this lets them do really powerful things, but it also means if your code crashes there, you crash the whole computer blue screen to death. The rule is that you try to do as little as you can in the kernel because you don't want to be the guy who crashes people's computer. If you look at Windows Defender, Microsoft's product, they've got this kernel driver that when it sees suspicious things, sends it out to a user space service that then has a whole database.
Outside the kernel.
Outside the kernel. And that's the same way Speedify works. We actually, in Windows, have a kernel driver too. We just have the tiniest little bit of code in the kernel necessary to do the job. With CrowdStrike, there's something really interesting. The file that crashed the kernel was a data file of what threats to look for that accidentally somehow got filled with zeros, which means they've actually got the database in the kernel module.
I would
call that a no-no. I would say that is too much.
How did an issue like this get through testing? Do you think they have a testing process?
So the story I'm hearing is that they do have a testing process and they did test it and there was no problem with it, but that they test somewhere in the middle of their continuous integration pipeline. Mm-hmm. After they were done testing, then they compressed it and encrypted it and did all these other things to the file that changed it. And there was a bug there that erased the contents of this file and filled it with nulls.
So the moral is test again.
You're going to have bad bugs.
Mm-hmm. Has Speedify pushed out bugs before?
Speedify has pushed out bugs before.
So is this Microsoft's fault?
No. They put out an interesting little statement on Friday that due to their settlement with the EU in 2009, they have to give competing security companies the same level of access to Windows, including the kernel, that they themselves have. So Microsoft says they're not even legally allowed to lock down the computer. And to be honest, I don't want them to. Kind of interesting, I'm not quite sure what's going on there, that Microsoft says that if you reboot the computer 15 times in a row, that it'll...
Without doing anything? Just reboot 15 times?
That's what they're saying. They're saying that if you reboot 15 times in a row, it'll stop loading their kernel module and you'll be able to proceed.
Just like some hidden protection in Windows? The latest news is that as the outage persists, the affected computers that haven't been fixed yet are vulnerable to hacking. Is that true?
Obviously, a computer that's currently blue screen and crashed is not vulnerable at all. It can't do anything. But if all you've done is delete that .sys file that was causing it to crash, all hackers need to do to crash computers like that now is get that .sys file back. There's a magic spot. You put a file and anyone with CrowdStrike, you blue screen them, right? Mm-hmm. So CrowdStrike has to get an uncrashable version of that kernel driver out to everyone, right? The short-term fix to delete that file is not enough.